that is. Showing us how to light up our living space with a DIY beaded chandelier that is really stunning is Maria. I love this idea, Maria.
Thank you. Yes, time consuming and stunning, for sure.
So it took some time.
It did,
you
but,
have been
you
working
know,
on it.
These are extremely expensive
they
in
are.
Stores right now. It's a big trend in home decor, these wood beaded chandeliers. But I will tell you, I think they're very expensive because of the sort of tediousness that goes into the making of it. But they're so worth it and so beautiful. And when you break it down, it's actually very simple to do.
Well, the cascading layers of the beads are so impressive, like we were just showing there. What do we need besides those beads? Where would I even get those beads?
Well, so the beads you can get at the craft supply store or online.
Okay.
They're very, very easy to find. Just keep in mind, if you are shopping online, make sure when you get the beads that they have holes on both sides.
Because they don't always.
I did make that mistake.
Uh-oh. Okay.
So just make sure you're looking for that. I used twine as my rope, basically.
Okay.
You can use twine. You could use some string. You don't really see it. You just want to make sure it's really sturdy.
Okay.
But that's why I stuck with the twine. A white string that's really strong could work as well. Don't use a thread or anything like that because that's not strong enough.
Okay.
You have your light and obviously the wood beads. So something that will make your life so much easier, these are called doll needles. This is very important when you're stringing them because these are long, but they're also wider for the twine to go into.
Okay.
And obviously some scissors, a glue gun, and your base of whatever you want it to be. This is really where like the world can be your oyster. You could use something that's like an embroidery hoop. This is actually the base of a lamp shade. So the thing I got was like, this is, it had a top and a bottom and a shade that went around it that I just took everything off of and just had my base here.
Of a lampshade, like a sitting lampshade.
It was a hanging one, but you could use a sitting one too because I'm just using the top part.
Oh, interesting.
Just using the metal top part of the wire top part.
Now, yes.
Now, before you start stringing the beads and get, in order to figure it all out and where the strings go, you say it's important to have your wire base hanging
exactly
in place or at least hanging for you.
Exactly. So what you see here, it was my sort of work in progress.
Yep.
This here was actually from a hanging flower basket that I just put on here. You could use string or anything like that.
Sure.
Get it to hang whatever way you can. And this is going to be what you want to do in order to get the sizing correct. Otherwise, you're going to lose your mind.
I love that you're recycling all these things, by the way.
Yes, exactly. I just try to, like, make my life easier. And these things are around the prop garage, luckily.
Yeah, true.
So what I did for this, I kind of had to work also with what the base of mine is because I have these three different things in here. So what I did is I took a ruler and separated everything evenly based on how long I wanted my swag to be. So this is just truly out of process of elimination.
Okay.
I started to string some beads. I wanted to see how long I wanted it to be.
Sure.
But I wanted it here, 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 and I knew I wanted a few layers of the beads. So it's truly just a process of elimination. Once I figured out what I wanted my length to be and sort of the spacing, that's where I figured out the spacing for everything. So there's 8 swags along here that are my length.
So this is called a swag.
This is, well, I call it my swag.
I like
that. So
it's
my swag.
I like it. So how do you create the swag?
So to create the swag, this is where the twine comes in and your doll needle. And this is, they're specifically called doll needles. You can get these at the craft supply store or online as well. So this is what I did. And a great tip too is don't cut your twine. You want to, because otherwise you don't want to do it too short and then you're like, oh no, I have to start all over again.
Right.
It takes a little bit of effort to get your twine through here. So I'll set it down a little bit more so you can kind of see. So you see it's a little thicker there, but this is one of the bigger needles you're going to use. So then you can do, once I figured out my spacing, sort of like you can see here, so I did, you know, about 10 here, 10 here, or 5 here.
And I like how you use different size beads, so you mix it up. And, of course, that depends on what you're looking to do. And you had the smaller ones on the outsides and the larger ones.
Yes, so that was sort of my vision where I wanted it to cascade a little bit from short to long.
I like that.
So you can see here, all I'm doing is this, and it makes your life so much easier. It's like stringing popcorn, and you can see it'll have some of the smaller ones as well. For instance, I just want to show you how all of them kind of go on.
Right.
So it can take a little bit of an elbow grease, but really just push it on there like that, and you will have yours. But you really can do whatever sizing you like. It's really, like I said, there's some in stores. They're really beautiful if they're all the same size. I've seen that. But I really had that vision of it cascading a little bit.
I like it with the different sizes. It makes it look more expensive.
It does make it look expensive.
And they are expensive.
Yeah. expensive. I mean, they are, but these would be even more, you know, because you can understand why they are expensive, because watching you do all,
So you can see it's not difficult, it's just time consuming.
You're right,
so
tedious.
I have all of mine here. What you want to do is you want to do the first layer of these, the longest layer first, and get them all on. You can't do one side and then go to the other.
Okay.
So I have here, so I'll show you all I did was, so here we go. This is on here, and lots of tying of knots. All I did is tie these into knots. And I do recommend doing just a really tight one knot, because you kind of can move these around.
Yep.
You see here.
But wait a minute.
And you follow here.
On the top?
Oh, so, oh, I just glued those on.
Oh, those are just glued
those
on?
Those are just, yeah, those are hot glued on.
Okay. So to cover that,
to cover all of this.
Exactly. And you can just, once these are on, you cut your string. So let me show you really quick. So this is what I did. I have these tied on here. So when you do one, the way I did it is the second one starts in the center below it. So if that makes sense, it's like, it's when you overlap, everything is under. So you underlap every single thing. So each one you do
back.
Starts at like, and you can, we'll have this, obviously this picture online, and you can use it as a reference, but you just go around, and when you do your layers, you have three layers. So this is the easy part. Once you have your spacing and your length figured out, just do all of the ones like I have laid out here.
Do them all the same.
Yeah.
I love that you use three layers like that. It seems to be just enough to kind of give enough of a shade look without it being kind of overwhelming, right?
Exactly.
You can still see.
Oh, yeah, that's a very good point.
And you still get to see that beautiful light bulb.
It's just enough. Yeah, I love that too.
What kind of light bulb is that?
Isn't that fun?
That's
so it has that really cool industrial look. So what's great about this is you are not limited to the light bulb that you have. It gives you the opportunity to get really creative and shop around. So this is just a big light bulb that did not go with the lamp that I had got. Just go shop, use anything you like. This is an LED one. But, yeah, that's really it. Just any kind of light bulb you want.
Great, creative, like Edison-style bulbs out there these days.
Yes.
You can get really, really
stylish. You could just Google cool light bulbs.
Yeah, for sure. It looks amazing as Maria keeps working on this
and
one.
And just secured with a hot glue gun. I just want to say, like, at the top. Yeah.
All so that's the top secured. Row with a hot glue gun?
Yeah. Hot glue and cut these off, hot glue, and then covered it with the smaller beads.
Because that top row along the wire base does kind of finish it off really nicely. It kind of cleans it up really beautifully. And it looks great in this lit room,
that's
but I'd love to see how it lights up
a room
in the dark.
Let's
Can we take
see
a look?
This
Do we have a photo of that?
Whoa. See? Oh, and I love the shadows it creates.
Oh, it's so.
Oh, Maria, that's beautiful.
Oh, it's worth every single strand of beef.